how to pass data in a modal and how to create model in Ionic 3 or Ionic 4. I will guide you here how to create the model. Suppose this is an app and I want to select the address on this page. On this page, I want to select the address. So I click on this and it says like enter the following things and I will give you the address. Suppose I am giving J prefix is K351. So it search one address for me, and as I click here, it come back with this data. So how actually this model is passing the data, and how this model is passing the data to the previous component, and how I can pass data from the root component to the model. Let's see first this register. This register is also a model. If I go back here, or if I press here, if I go back here, it's coming in register page. So once I click on this register, it's open a model. If you can see here, if I want to click, I can't click anywhere because this is a model. Downside, if I'm clicking it, it will not work. First, this is a model. Let me show you how this model is being loaded. So this is the code of an existing application. So I'm performing this click. If I am performing this click, it's opening that model for me, this model for me. So there's no need of that much of code. So I have commented. So what I am doing here, I'm just creating a model controller model with a register model. Register model is actually a component. Component I have created, model component. And here I am passing data in JSON format like device ID and model selected. This model selected and device ID I am passing along with the component while creating the model. And I am assigning this model object on a variable, location model, some I have named here, location model, and just I am presenting it. So this is how it's opening this model. And in same way, if I go to this model, suppose this is register model, if I come here for address selection and the lift ID selection something. So if you see select location is also being created as a model, as a location service. But here I am not passing any parameter to the child model because I don't require that. This model is this by default by searching a few locations and all. So I'm just creating here a simple model, location selection model. But if you see in the select lift ID, which is down here, this select to create this model, I am passing data again, zip code and device ID. So again, I'm passing parameter to the model to get it created. And when the model, so once the model work get over, so when the model will dismiss, this will return some data to the root model or to the root component from where it's being created. So you can see here I am loading lift select model. And if you come here on lift select model, where you can see this is the lift select model page. And same name here I am passing. Lift select model page, if I am not wrong. So when you come here on confirm, there is a method on confirm in this model. You will see like when I select this, it gives for lift letter and switch addresses. So on confirmation, if I select some data like 214, whatever, if I confirm here, it given me some data like A5 and B3, like lift ID is A5 and B3. So how this data is coming to the root page or the creator page of that model? So here is one method like on dismiss. So when the model view will dismiss, then I'm passing data. So there is a callback attached with the model like on dismiss callback. So when on the dismiss callback will be called, and it will find if some data is being returned from the child model or not. So this is how the ionic model behaves. I think for version ionic 3 and ionic 4 or 5, the behavior is same. The only one change is there in ionic 4 and 5 is to add a weight here on the creating model when it's being returned, or you have to await for the completion of the creation of the model and all. So this is the one change in the version 3 to version 5 of the Ionic framework. Once the data is being passed to the model creation, like we call param, here you how you will cache the data, how you will cache the data which is being passed in param. So here is one navparams module in ionic hyphen angular, or you can get it at the rate ionic/angular in ionic 5. Is the handler who catches the navigation parameters, whatever you are passing from one page to other page, or one navigation to other navigation. So navparam will catch those data. So this is how it works. So I have created one params here with navparam of type navparam, and I am getting this by param dot get zip code and device ID. What I am passing device ID code and zip code is being cached here by params navparam. And this navparam is very helpful when you are passing the data from one model to other and one page to other through a navigation panel. So it's very helpful in that. So hope you have learned how to pass the data through navigation and how to create the model in Ionic 3, 4 or either 5. This is the way you can create the model. And when you are going to dismiss the model, you can pass back data to the root controller or the creator of that model. It works. Thanks for watching.